Hey guys, Assalamualaikum, it's Jenna G. Welcome back to my channel. So today we are doing yet another favorite holiday treat that we like to enjoy here in Trinidad. So you would have seen me do a fruitcake. I did a fruitcake with no alcohol sometime back. I also did eggnog. I did sorrel as well. So I'll post the links to all those videos down below. And I recently did a pastel one just to add to the holiday end of year sort of time here in Trinidad. So in case you guys want to see how to do those videos, check out the links down below to see the full videos, of course. So today we're going to be doing another easy recipe, another easy one, and this time it's going to be on sweet bread. Now you want to stay tuned to the end of the video because husband insists that he share his super easier version of sweet bread. So in the meantime, let's jump into this one. But before we jump into the video, you know you guys gotta hit that subscribe button and also the bell notification button as well. That is just to make sure that you don't miss out on any of my videos to come. So we're just gonna jump into the ingredients that I'm gonna be using for this sweet bread recipe real quickly. So I'm gonna be using some all-purpose flour, and in there I've already got some baking powder as well. I'm gonna be using some brown sugar in this recipe. Brown sugar tends to go best in baking dishes, so we're going to be using brown sugar. I have some raisins, some cherries, some mixed fruit, some essence. You can use mixed essence. I'm using vanilla essence today. I've got some melted margarine. I've got some coconut milk as well as water, so it's half half. I'm going to be using some nutmeg, some freshly grated nutmeg, and of course some cinnamon powder. Don't forget, we need the coconut as well. And let's just talk about this coconut for a second. So these days, everything is made a lot more convenient for us and are made to make things easier, right? So this that I'm gonna be using is actually grated coconut that you can easily find in just about any supermarket in Trinidad. So it's grated coconut that you're going to be using. But of course, if you want to go the traditional way, you can use the dry coconut. You can pick that up at the market, at the veggie stalls, even at the supermarket. And there's a little process to follow when you're going to be using that. So I'll probably show you guys a little clip of a video I have from when my dad was making his pilau and he used fresh coconut in it. So basically you just need to crack it open. Usually I remember back in the day we used to go hit it on the concrete or something like that, but of course if you want to save the water from it to do whatever you need to do with it, you want to cut it a little over like a bowl or something. But the fun thing about it back in the day was just going and pelting it onto the concrete ground and let it break apart. And then once you've cut it open, you're going to remove the outer brown layer, and once you've removed that layer, you want to chip up the flesh part of it, and you can grate it into small pieces, and that's what this basically is here. And you can also make the coconut milk from it by adding it to like a blender, throwing some water and mix it up. So you can check out that short clip right here.
It's a skill. So this is the inside of the coconut, which is the coconut, the shell of the coconut.
You got all clean, boy.
Yes, it takes some skill. Right. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to just prepare it. Storage bowl. Is that the bowl you just asked about? Alright, so these are my bowls. Oh, this is what you need. You see that?
That's things we already do again. You just buy coconut milk from the can. And
so this is real stuff.
But of course, these days, like I said, lots of things are made so much easier for us and make things a lot more convenient. So we go with this way, of course. And husband kind of giving me the look like, really using this? I'm not the fresh one. But yes, honey, I am. All right, so now let's jump into the video. This is a super easy pretty sweet bread recipe. It's pretty simple to actually make this. The bake time is what actually takes up the majority of the time. So let's just combine everything and put it to bake. So to start off, I'm going to combine all the dry ingredients. So I've got my flour and my baking powder in here. I'm going to be adding the sugar. The nutmeg and the ground cinnamon. You want to mix everything so everything is nicely incorporated. We add in the raisins, cherries, and the mixed fruit. In goes the grated coconut. Next, we're going to just be combining all the wet ingredients. So I've got my coconut milk and water. Got my melted butter, or melted margarine, I should correctly say, and in goes the essence. So I'm just going to whisk everything. And now I'm going to be adding it to the dry ingredients. So you want to mix it until everything is nicely incorporated. You don't want to over mix it. And now what I'm going to be doing is adding it to two greased bread pans that I have. And we're going to pop this in the oven at 350. We're going to bake it for about 45 minutes. We're going to take it out of the oven and we're just going to add a little glaze, which is just basically a combination of sugar and water. So let's pop them into the oven and let them bake. For the glaze, I'm just using sugar and water. I'm just going to mix it up, paste this onto, or add this onto the top of the sweetbread. We're going to pop it back into the oven for about 5 minutes. Now you can just use a toothpick to check to see if the bread is properly cooked through and poke it in. Once it comes out clean, it's fine. So we say about between 50 and 60 minutes bake time total. They smell really nicely. So now I'm just going to use the sugar water and just paste it onto the top. Now notice this pan is a lot, it's small in this pan, but that's the only size that I had. So I could have actually made one large one, but chose to do it smaller size. So of course you can, well, depending on the pan, you know, y'all could adjust, but this is just what I had to work with. So I'm brushing this on and then I'm just going to pop it back into the oven. And just for some added touch, you could sprinkle on some brown sugar just on top. It's been 50 minutes. Let's just check it and see. So it came out clean. So that means it's all done. Alright guys, and that is it for my sweetbread recipe. The entire house, the entire kitchen just smells so nice. I'm going to let it cool and then we'll slice it up to see what it looks like. But let's just talk about the baking pans, the bread pans that I use. So I know some of you guys might ask, you know, why this one looking so flat or not full to the pan. Well, the truth is, I wanted smaller sweetbreads and I ideally I like this size, which is, I think it's an 8x4, yeah, it's an 8x4 pan, and ideally this to me is like a nice sweetbread pan. But because I did not have two in it, I tried to just split the mixture kind of evenly, so it's like a little flat. Now this is what I would use for like a bread recipe, so you get a nice big bread, but it's okay. So if you have your bread pans, ideally you can fill enough batter to cover like 3/4 of the pan and let it bake. So again, just what I had to use with and just what I used. So, you know, be careful what size that you have at home. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Try it out. It's pretty simple and pretty delicious. Some people like to eat it as it's out of the oven, slice it up and eat it nice and warm. Others, like they did, I've heard some people eat it with butter as well, but I don't know. It's all up to you, I guess. A slice of this and like a hot cup of tea or coffee, some people enjoy that. So thanks so much for watching, and of course, look out for a lot more videos to come. I hope you guys enjoyed my sweetbread video. Be sure to give it a try out. This dude, like I mentioned in the beginning, he said he has a real easy way of making sweetbread.
Real easy, guys. I'll show you the ingredients now and make it for you in less than 30 seconds. First of all, pay attention. You need a knife, butter knife will work. You need one of these, which is a can opener. You need bread because it's sweet bread, sliced bread. So you're gonna take out two slices. Bada bing, bada boom. Put it in a plate. And then the key ingredient, guys, is sweetened condensed milk. This is the best sweet bread you'll ever eat. Besides, you want your bacon right now, which you'll see in a short while, or you would have seen already. The hardest part with this, guys, is the opening of the condensed milk. In case you don't know, you need to punch a hole on either side. One is for the milk to come out and one is for the air to escape, so the milk will come out easily. So, bread, condensed milk. Whoa. Try to get it as evenly as possible. I mean, that's where I have the knife for, to smooth it out. Don't put too much because you will get diabetes. Pretty smooth already. Whoa. More water besides mine. Yours? Take next size of bread. Wait for it. Here we go. 1, 2, 3 sweet bread. How long that take?
I told you it's ready coming to show a proper sweet bread.
How is that?
Recipe.
This is a proper sweetbread recipe. Comment below who loved this sweetbread.
Not the correct way to make a sweetbread, guys.
Oh, you want a big one? That's in the next video, so stay tuned for that.
But so as usual, thanks so much for watching. Try out my sweetbread recipe, of course. If you want to try his own too, well, feel free, go right ahead.
Comment below. If you ever tried this before, how is this? Think I might.
No.
You can only do one half at a time, guys. Save the next half for tomorrow. Thanks for watching.
See you guys in the next video.